brothers and sisters. Greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Emmanuel, DCF Uganda. Greetings from Uganda. Greetings from Uganda. Greetings from Masaka. And greetings from DCF family. I send special greetings to our long-time friends, Pete and wife Simi, David and wife Helen. We love you so much. And thank you for being great friends. You've stood with us. In grief, we have grieved together. And in joy, we have also celebrated together. We thank you very much and we love you. May God continue blessing you. DCF is a family. And we love you for being part of this family. We are nothing else but a family. And together, we work as a family. There is nothing much I can say about DCF. But I can only say that God has blessed us as a family. And DCF is a family indeed. Dear members, I just want, behind me is our DCF workshop. As you can see, it's a donation. As the name reads, it's Donation Connection Foundation. Indeed, it is a donation. Whatever you see behind here, and whatever you will see inside here, is indeed a miracle. It came to us as a miracle. There is nothing that has come out of it just because of our effort. It is a miracle, and Brother Pete, Brother David, know that indeed this workshop here, Brother Pete loves to call it a workshop, has come as a miracle. It is here, the purpose of this workshop is to empower, to teach capital skills to the community members here for self-sustenance, because DCF is all about self-sustenance, and therefore this workshop is over here to teach carpentry skills for self-sustenance. I invite you inside here to see the activities that will take place in the carpentry workshop. Thank you very much. Dear brothers and sisters, we are inside our carpentry workshop now. There are activities, several activities going on here. There are two different categories of people who are inside here. The first category, we have the trainees, including myself. I'm putting on the one putting on just because it was raining, and because of this cultural activity, I just wanted to put on this coat and gumboots, but after, I'll put on my overall and then back to business. So we have the trainees. Those are the people that come here to earn, to be trained, or to have life skills, more so carpentry life skills. Then we have another category of people who already have the skills, and so they come here to work and earn IT. Those are the different categories of people that we have inside here. The number keeps on growing day by day. We only have limited resources, and therefore we cannot accommodate many of them. But we pray and we hope that God will provide, and we shall be able to have as many as possible. Let us go and see the particular items that we are doing right now. Over here, I don't know the name you would give to this particular piece of item. But what we do, we use this thing to hang on stories. As you can see, we have a problem here for it was brought here so that we can move it and put back. So we are trying to improve it so that the customer or the owner can have something new and something in the condition. Over here, this is a baby side drawer. This is the top of its kind. What happens, this one goes with the bed here. After the completion of this bed, then we shall have this bed side drawer being taken by the customer with the bed itself. The bed down there is being vanished.
the owner, the customer, wanted it to vanish. And so that is what we are doing. And then after maybe 2 or 3 days, it will be done, and then the customer will take it. Like I've said, this is a bedside drawer, and to go alongside with the bed, that is when it is done. Over here, you would take this one to be a closet. Only that this one is not closed. And what will happen, we put hang lines here, and then we can have closets here, and then down here, we can also have space where to put activation. So one can have it in his or her own home, and actually when it is complete, it looks very beautiful. Maybe I'll send a picture to look at the, furniture piece of this, so that you can see the kind of art that a kind of carpenter can have. For this side, this is a shutter, an ordinary shutter. The custom is not going to vanish it. It is going to stay the way it is. And so we only beautify it and making it better. And then after that, the customer will take it. And of course, he will close his house. And I think the customer is actually, after this video, the customer is taking it away, because I think it is complete now. Right away here, this is our workshop bench. Rather to get correctly that it's called a workshop bench. And so this is where we do much of the work, and this is where most of the work is done. This is a workshop bench, and this is where most of the work is done from. Now, as you can see, there are things that we cannot do from here. For example, the designs that make up this. We don't have machines that make up these designs. So we have to move around 10 miles from here to make sure that we can have these designs. Otherwise, if we had the machines to make up these designs, then it would be far much better. We spend a lot of time in transport, and actually time. That is what time, so we cannot reach very many orders, because we need to take this piece of wood to a machine and then have these designs made for us, and then back on a border, and then we come and then do the rest of the work. It is a little bit tedious and it wastes much of time, but of course we do that because we love the work that we are doing. But what is being done here, this is a new bed. This is a new bed that is being fixed. This new bed, of course, will take around 3-4 days to be complete. There is a lot of work going on here, and indeed, without the effort of Bosco, who is our trainer, then nothing much can be done. Most of us are training, and so he does all the art that is needed to make sure that we can have a complete bed. By the way, in the introduction, I did not introduce to you Bosco, who is over here. Bosco, you can look in the camera there, who is our trainer. And he can wave at you and know that he's the one behind all the activities going on here. So, Brother Pete knows much about Bosco, and I believe Brother David too knows about Bosco, because I've sent several pictures to them about Bosco and what is going on here.
We have to travel around 10 miles from here to make sure these designs are made, because we don't have the machines that can make these designs yet. They are very, very important, most especially in producing quality piece of furniture. Now, as you can see, much of the work that is being done here is physical. Our workshop has no power. We don't have power, we don't have electricity. So much of the work is physical. Now, there are several disadvantages in that. One, it takes long to complete a certain piece of work. It takes long and takes much time for one of us to complete any given assignment. And we pray that maybe God can provide, and then we have a generator. I also am told that the solar system can also work and be used for that purpose. And so that we can have power here, and when God provides, then we can have tools or machines, or powered machines that can be used for some of the work inside here. Now, this is our cramp. And of course, as you can see, this is the only cramp that we have. Now, when you look at the numbers inside here, with one clamp, indeed you can see that it needs really takes a lot of time if really we need to use this clamp at all. Now, we also have a spoke shape, and it's the only spoke shape that we have. So when you look at the numbers here, and versus the one spoke shape that we have, you can see that we still really need a lot of prayers to make sure that we can have more tools to do some of the work here. Now, this is a drill. Unfortunately, we don't have power. So it is just here for decoration. Otherwise, when God provides and we are able to have power inside here, then this drill will be given some work to do. Now, some of these planes are out of function. I told Pete, oh brother Pete, that we failed to fix or to get spare parts to fix these planes here. We only have one working plane, and that is why at times it takes us long to do some of the work, because we have to share that one plane. Then over here we have what we call a bow saw. This is called a bow saw, and it is only one of this kind here. So that means that we also have to share this bow saw in case any of us wants to use it. Over here we also have a wood rasp. This is what we call a wood rasp. And of course, as you can see, somebody is using it here. And in case somebody over there wants to use it, then he has to wait for the one using it to finish, and then he uses two. So we only have this one that we are here to share. And I don't know whether there is something else that I've not shown you. Maybe I can also show you. So we have one hand saw, and this is the hand saw that we have to use all of us. And of course, in case somebody is using it, that means that one has to wait until he's done, so that we can also use the same hand saw. Now, of course, briefly, that is what we do in our DCF workshop. Like I mentioned before, much of the work that is done here is physical. We don't have power input here, and so we have to put in effort to make sure that we produce a particular carpentry piece. Now, the journey that we have learned over time, the importance and the efficiency of powered tools. Take an example. Now, I have this one plane here. In case I want to do something, or to plane this piece of wood, I would use this plane. Then after planing, I will use sand paper to make it smooth. That means two different tasks done at two different intervals. With a grinder, the two pieces of work will be done just at once. And so making the work easier and making the work faster. So those are some kind of challenges that we have inside here. But we pray and we look unto God that He will provide, and we shall be able to have power in here, maybe a generator, maybe a solar system, and then we shall have more tools, that is our prayer, and then we shall have powered tools, that is our prayer, and then we can do work efficiently. I should say or mention that DCF workshop is saving lives of our community. More people are coming in here to learn skills for self-sustainance, because basically what we do here is self-sustainance, and that is what we are building. Now, if we are empowered and we can sustain ourselves independently, then we are also able to help some other people who will be in need. Dear brothers and sisters, that is my presentation. I just want to thank you once again for praying for us. Thank you for praying for us. Thank you for loving us. And thank you for being part of DCF family. We love you so much. In my next video, I will show you what we have turned to be
the magic, the miracle in this is for the children. Brother Bill knows about it. Brother David knows about it. And it is indeed a miracle to us. And therefore, in my next video, that is what I will show. And then I also show some bit of what we are doing in the tailoring workshop that we are trying to do and we are setting. Thank you very much. May the good Lord protect you. May the good Lord bless you. Thank you.